I'm Roger Donaldson, and I'm the director of the McLaren film. Everybody, you know, knows about McLaren cars, but few people know why a McLaren is called a McLaren. And I remember going back many, many years ago, seeing Bruce McLaren race. I got his father to lend me a car for one of my movies, so I sort of felt like I knew who McLaren was. And then when the opportunity to make this film came along, I was hooked. What a great opportunity to explore something from my past, a character that I think is, you know, really important in the history of motor racing. And so that's how I came to be involved. The story of Bruce McLaren is one of a sort of a young guy who had a passion passed down to him from his father. That passion was motor racing, but it's like any passion that you have, you know, it takes a lot of perseverance to really make it into something. And Bruce had a talent both for, as a car designer, a passion for auto racing, and he had the talent as a driver. And he managed to get himself from New Zealand to the UK, where he started the McLaren Car Company. He bought a bunch of fellow like-minded Kiwi mechanics with him and met up with like-minded Brits here, and together they started the McLaren Car Company. And back in the 60s, it was a very dominant brand, especially in auto racing in America, actually. The real challenge of making this film was finding the film to make the film with. Back in the 60s, you know, television didn't exist in the same way. Sports weren't covered like they are now. So finding, you know, the footage to make this film was a real challenge. We managed, through the help of Amanda McLaren and the Jan McLaren, his sister, who's still alive. They had a lot of archival footage and home movies and stuff like that, so that was a great basis to start the film from. And then from around the world, we managed to track down lots of other archival material, and that was really the basis for this film. There was everything from sort of, you know, interviews with his mum and his dad, and there was this great collection of recording tapes. When Bruce first came to the UK, he would make tapes home to his family, and those tapes really did tell the story of a young man, you know, on the other side of the world trying to start his motor racing career, and they had a great sense of humour. The friends that he came here with were in the tapes as well, so those tapes really were something very personal, and it was Bruce's voice, and so we were able to get, you know, Bruce's real voice in the movie. One of the things that's happening, there's been a real revolution in, you know, how films are being distributed. If you're interested in a particular subject now, you can get on to Amazon or Netflix or one of those services, and you can stream a film that you're interested in. And I think, you know, I know when I'm on an aeroplane, for instance, I would much prefer to watch a documentary than watch a dramatic film, because there's something about a real story with the real people in it that really sucks you in a way that maybe sometimes a scripted film can't quite achieve. Well, what's the attraction of motorsport? I don't know. I guess once upon a time it was horse racing, and then along came the motor car, and people like my grandfather, you know, bought the flashiest, fastest car they could buy and drove it too fast down the roads, and then, you know, you were banned from driving your car on the road, so then the crazy drivers would get together and see who could drive the fastest between two points on the map. And so it's, you know, it's hard to give it a real reason other than it's just foolhardy guys trying to go fast, outdo each other, prove that they are braver and more stupid and crazy than the other. But there's something about the magic of watching car racing, seeing, you know, how entertaining it can all be.